Namaskaram. In this Agni Initiative video, we are going to explore about GMO foods and whether it is beneficial to have them. So GMO, as you know, stands for genetically modified organism, which means that their DNA has been modified in a lab. It has been genetically engineered, whether it's a plant or microorganism or an animal. So it is we meddling with nature, what is natural. So Sadhguru was mentioning about this, that this is something which is highly irresponsible, driven mainly by commercial forces, and it is meddling with nature, and this is definitely something which we should try to avoid. So there are a lot of countries who have even planned to ban GMO foods because of the adverse effects it is supposed to have on human health, negative impacts on the environment, and how it can affect traditional farming practices. So it has so many consequences, ethical, there are so many ethical issues involved with GMO foods. So it is best if you can avoid GMO foods. So it is important that you are aware about which foods are genetically modified. So whenever you buy a food, you should be aware whether it is something which is natural or which is GMO. For example, you will see corn which is the natural variety. You will also see corn which is genetically modified, which is like sweet corn. So you should be careful about what foods you are consuming, because many of the foods which we are getting, it could be genetically modified. For example, even in brinjal, they have something called as BT brinjal or something like that, which is like a genetically modified variety of that vegetable. So when you consume foods, you can be aware of that, and if you find that something is genetically modified or engineered, this is predominantly being done to just to see how productivity can be enhanced, or more economic benefit can come from these kind of activities. Because generally, if you see that in nature itself, the way everything is structured, or how your DNA is being created or structured, is it's built in certain way that you have all necessary ingredients to live a life. But with human greed, what's happening is they're trying to get maximum from whatever it is, whether it's a plant or animal or whatever. They're trying to see how you can squeeze more out of it, and GMO is one consequence from this, where you're trying to genetically modify the DNA. You're trying to genetically modify it in such a way that the yield can increase, etc. So this is something, the moment you're going away from what's natural, what is being prescribed in nature, you will see that this is something which can potentially be hazardous for one's health. So try to see if you can avoid GMO foods. So one simple thing you can do is check whatever foods you are buying to see whether it is GMO or not, because not many foods nowadays could be genetically modified. And especially governments in different countries, they can take a step in banning these foods, then it could percolate to the lowest level. Otherwise, for most people, they may not have the awareness in terms of what it is. For example, a lot of variety of soya which is available is genetically modified. So there are many foods like this which are genetically modified, and people are not even aware about this. So see if you can be a little more aware when you are buying foods, and try to avoid genetically modified foods as much as possible. See if you can eat natural foods, foods which are grown with traditional farming practices, which come from the earth, where the DNA is not being meddled with. It's something which is natural. It is the indigenous variety or the native variety. So that is something which you can try to include in your diet. So please experiment with this and share your experience with us. Namaskar.
If you eat food and your body feels very agile and alive, that means it's good food, body is liking it. If you eat something it feels dull, that means it's not liking it, it's having difficulty with it. That's why it feels dull.
Namaskaram. For those of you looking to explore about food in depth, we also have an online program on food called as Ahar. So we have a website called as ahar.yogire.com, which will have more details about this program. If you are looking to grow on the path of yoga, then food is as important as sadhana. So it's very important that you see what kinds of foods to eat which can assist you in this inner journey, and more importantly also how to eat. So we'll be looking at this in depth in this online program, and this can be done from the comfort of your home. From wherever you are, you can log in and do this program. So if you wish to explore this in depth, please log into our Ahar website and you can see if this is something which can help you take a step towards your inner growth. And we hope that the simple process of eating can also become a stepping stone towards your ultimate well-being. Thank you so much. Namaskaram.